Hello future engineers, welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're still new to my channel and you like what I'm doing, please don't forget to share my videos to your friends and to your friends' friends, to your younger brothers and sisters who would want to take up engineering in the future, and to your relatives. Now, if you find my videos interesting and important to your studies, also please don't forget to subscribe. Here is Vitamath 32, and supposedly only the students in the engineering level can understand this, but I am open to the possibilities that high school students can also understand this, but more so to those who are now reviewing for their respective licensure exams. I hope that you can follow the presentation, solutions, and the derivations here. So, derive the law of secants and the associated principles on the angle between secants. A secant line is a line that crosses a circle at two points. So, that's a secant line. But if it only touches a point, then the secant line can be reduced to a tangent line also. So, is the circle, and we have two secants, namely PA and PB. The angle between secants is theta, and we'll develop an expression for this later. But you have to take note that by definition, an inscribed angle or peripheral angle is equal to 1/2 the angle occupied by its subtended arc, and that is already derived in the preceding Vitamath problem. So if you cannot recall, then you have to review that specific Vitamath problem so that you can follow the explanation and derivation here. So take note that these secants intercept two arcs of the circle, namely this longer arc AB and this shorter arc AC. But let's form triangles here. So let's connect DB and AC as shown, and CD and AB. We will call this angle here angle PAC as alpha as shown, and this alpha here subtends this arc. So it subtends this arc, which is the same arc CD subtended by this angle here. So therefore, by principle, and in the preceding Vitamath problem, this is also alpha. So even if the point, remember, if the point moves around the circle except this portion here, the point may move anywhere and it subtends this arc CD here, the angle subtended will not change. It is always alpha. So if we call this angle here beta, the third angle, then we form two similar triangles. This triangle here, where the first two angles are alpha and theta, and the other triangle is this triangle here with the same first two angles alpha and theta. So if we call this beta, and we have alpha and theta here, so therefore this angle, the measure of this angle is also beta, as indicated. So we have two similar triangles, namely triangles APC and triangle BPD. So triangles APC and BPD are similar. So if they are similar, corresponding ratios of their sides are equal. So that's it. That is. So let's have opposite of alpha as to opposite of beta principle. So opposite of alpha in APC is PC, and opposite of beta is PA. So PC as to PA equals, here, alpha is PD, opposite of alpha in this triangle is PD, and the opposite of beta is PB. So by cross multiplication, PA PD times PA equals PC times PB. And that's the law of seconds. So that you can remember this law of seconds, it means that the product of the external second, we call this external second PD, and the second line, original second line PA, is equal to the external, the product of the external second of the other second line, which is PC, times the second line PB. So I hope that it is clear in this diagram. So that's the law of seconds. Then, let's have this angle here, theta. Take note that this theta, which is the angle between the seconds, which lies outside the circle, it subtends two arcs, AB and CD. Remember, if that point lies on the circle, the measure of that angle is 1/2 the measure of the subtended arc. Here, there are two arcs subtended. So I hope that for one peripheral angle or inscribed angle, if the point lies on the circle, it only subtends this arc here. So that's why alpha is 1/2 of the corresponding angle occupied by its subtended arc. So that is the principle. Remember, for inscribed and peripheral angle. So here, there are two arcs subtended. So I hope that you'll have an idea that it is 1/2 the sum of the angles subtended or occupied by its subtended arcs. So we have angle AB, which is represented by the central angle, and angle CD, central angle CD. So let us show that theta is 1/2 the measure of the angle occupied by its subtended arcs. So I'll draw a line DD prime, which is parallel to PB. So if these two lines are parallel and the measure of this angle is theta, so this angle, the measure of this angle is also theta, because this is just the extension of PD, the second line PA, and this is parallel to that line. Therefore, the measure of that angle is also equal to that angle there. By principle, because D is now on the circle, theta is 1/2 of this subtended arc, 1/2 of arc AD, or simply 1/2 of the angle occupied by arc AD, and we will call that theta AD prime. And that angle is equal to, or that arc is equal to arc AB. This arc AD prime is arc AB minus arc D prime B. So if we denote this angle here as theta AD prime, theta sub AD prime, then theta is 1/2 of theta AD prime. So angle occupied by its subtended arc. Then from the figure, theta AD prime is equal to this angle here, theta AB minus theta D prime B. So theta is 1/2 of theta AB minus theta D prime B. And this angle theta B D prime B is also the angle CD, because these two lines are parallel. So theta is therefore 1/2 of theta AB minus theta of CD, where theta CD is the measure of this angle. Theta D prime B is also this angle, which is the same. So if I call this angle theta AB, and this one is theta D prime B, and that theta D prime B is also equal to the angle occupied by the subtended arc of the 2 seconds CD, as shown in the figure. So this is theta CD, which is equal to theta D prime B. But I will use theta CD. So that's why we use theta CD here. So that's the definition of theta angle between 2 seconds. 1/2 of theta AB minus theta CD. So that you can recall this is 1/2 the measure of its subtended one half, the difference of its subtended arcs. So we have theta AB, which is subtended by these 2 seconds, and the other subtended angle or subtended arc is CD, theta CD. So one half quantity theta AB minus theta CD. That's it. Then let's have the extension of the law of seconds. So we have second line, and because this line touches only once at one point on the circle, this is called tangent line. But we can still form 2 similar triangles here. So we draw that line and that line there. So if we call that alpha, since the point A may move anywhere on the circle and the angle subtended by arc BD will always be alpha, except the extreme points where that point can still move and subtend this arc is when it is at B or at D. When it is at B, this is the tangent line and this is the chord. This is the other chord. So the measure of that angle is also alpha, because it subtends arc BD also, so that's also alpha. So we have 2 similar triangles, namely APB and BPD. So we have the first 2 angles alpha theta, so call that beta. So this angle is also the entire angle here, because we have the first 2 angles alpha and theta, so this is also beta. So we have 2 similar triangles, triangles APB and BPD. So corresponding ratio of sides equal. So let's have opposite of alpha as to opposite of beta. So opposite of alpha PB as to opposite of beta PA. So PB as to PA is equal to opposite of alpha here is PD, and opposite of beta is PB. So PD over PB. By cross multiplication, PA times PD equals PB times PB. So this is the extension of the law of secants. There's no secant. It is just tangent and tangent. So if we're going to interpret this result, the external secant, the product of the external secant of 1 secant line and the secant line, PD times PA, is equal to external secant, which is the tangent, and the secant reduces to a tangent also. That's why we have PB times PB. And you don't need to recall this, just the principle of inscribed angle or peripheral angle, then form 2 similar triangles. Then from there, you can derive this law of secants and the extension of the law of secants. So that's it for this problem. I hope that you were able to understand it, follow the derivations, and I hope that your knowledge in geometry is again enhanced, added. I hope that you can apply this to future problems where you can encounter situations where we have circles and secants.